Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. God is good. All the time God is good. Amen. I praise and thank God for all the fortunate ones who are celebrating Father's Day. I wish them in return happy Father's Day. And likewise, all the fortunate ones who also have the grandparents as well, fathers and grandparents. Uncle touched upon just now, Sundara uncle touched upon the roots. I'll not take much time. I'll just go back again to the definition as uncle just started off. And I have a small testimony after this, which I'll use it within this time frame as well. When I was young, my dad passed early. I was not fortunate enough. That's why I started that statement. But during those years, these are the forming years, we observe them, we look at them, and we learn from them. What I learned from my father at the age of 18, I lost my dad. But today I rejoice. I rejoice his learnings, his teachings, which I feel are very valuable. Not only learning within the family, but also I carry forward so that the next generation I can pass on to. The F letter here, I looked at him, and when I was remembering today, he instilled, he said that fear of the Lord is very important. When you say that you believe in Christ and you come from a believer's family, we need to be faithful. More importantly, fear of the Lord is what we need, not only in our lives, but also in the house. Second, he said, accepting Jesus Christ as your Savior. Have you accepted Jesus Christ as a Savior? That is something which is very critical. Now, a father can teach many things, but accepting Jesus Christ leaves a big question mark. It's not an easy path to go. The T letter, it stands for the teachings. Teachings, treating others. Treat others as you expect others to treat unto yourself. That's the word that we learn always. So his teachings, the teachings, I always believed in it. What we teach at home, what we speak at home, what we teach our kids at home, it matters a lot. My dad used to always tell me, if you need to know how the house is, what's the temperature, T, the temperature in the house, he said, go and talk to the kids. You'll know the temperature in the house, whether it's hot or cold. So T, he said, very important, because of that, you'll come to know what's happening, because that's what they carry forward. Not only within the house, at the school, or anywhere they go. T, again, what they stand for. Do they stand for trust? Do they stand for testimony? And testing times are always there. Trials, testing times are always there. What do we do? You need to be a testimony. That's what I learned from him. Wherever we go, we need to be a testimony. H, we always learn from the Bible. Honor the father and the mother. One of the commandments. Can't go wrong there. We need to honor them. No mistakes. Young, adult, anyone, we need to honor them. E, what of God showed us, the E, the everlasting love. The everlasting love, do we carry that? Do we have that? Or do we show that? It's on our character that we show. Because that love will take us to the eternal life. Right? That's what Jesus Christ showed us when he was here. R, the last letter. Very important, very powerful. I learned from my dad. He said that if you have to accept Jesus Christ, the first thing we need to do is repent. We need to repent ourselves. Repent for all the sins. Once we repent, then comes the reconciliation. We need to reconcile. If you're not repenting, if you're not accepting Jesus Christ, you're not reconciling with God, what is it that leading to? Because he said, once you have all this, the last thing that happens is wonderful and it is great. You know what he said? He said, the revelation that you get from all this is very key, very important, very powerful. He said, that take that revelation with you and don't keep it to yourself. Take it spread it. That's what he said. So I'm thankful to whatever I learned from my dad, and as a legacy, I'll pass it on to my kids. I know it's many people with collective wisdom here, but I feel we always look up to the Lord for His guidance, His wisdom. Thank you. And this time, I would like to share a quick testimony why I want to come here. The T word here, I want to say, I want to be thankful to Lord Jesus. Why do I need to be thankful here today? In moments of trials, in moments of testing times, it's God in whom we look up. I will lift my hands unto the Lord. From where does my help comes from? My help comes from the Creator who has created me. So He is the Creator. He knows us even before we are born. He's seen us in the womb of our mother. So if He has created it, He will give us the strength to withstand and to get out of it. Even though I've passed through the shadow valley of death, I will not fear because I know that He is there for me. We as a family, me and my wife, Lavanya, passed through that shadow of valley of death. I will not get into the details. But all I can say, we looked up to Him. We looked up to Him. And amazingly, see, with God, there is no logic. We need to always remember, there is no logic with God. He is pure magic. He is pure, pure magic. But we need to do our part. When the doctors are saying, it's not possible. The doctor said, not possible. This is regard to with my little one, Nissi. Me and my wife, Lavanya, we hold our hands together to the doctor and we said, you do your part. We will do our part. We will look up to the Lord. You tell what the problem is. You know what? Go and tell the problem that we have Jesus Christ with us. That's what we said, and we passed through it, and we came out with a flying colors, magical colors. Of course, all this wouldn't have been possible with the prayers of the church. I'm thankful to God, thankful to the church, and thankful for each and everyone who prayed for us and our family. And today, I'm standing here celebrating as a Father's Day for one of my kids. I'm thankful and grateful to all the values that my dad installed in me. I will pass it on. Thank you for this time. Praise God.